In this tutorial, I'm going to show how to record audio in PowerPoint slide by slide so that someone can play your presentation and hear you explaining each slide. This approach is an easy way to share a lecture or conference presentation with others. If you wish to also record your image to appear as a picture-in-picture along with the PowerPoint slides, you'll need to take a different approach, which I'll cover in another tutorial. First, you'll need to prepare your PowerPoint presentation. Here's one of my presentations I'm going to use for this tutorial. Prepare your slides and order them in the appropriate sequence. Then use the Notes option to write out what you plan to say. Alternatively, you can just work from separate lecture notes, but you want to avoid making a lot of page-turning noises. Either way, working from notes will help you remember everything you wish to say and to keep your presentation as brief as possible. In other words, don't try your audience's patience with a lot of rambling digressions. The next step is to record the audio for each slide. The exact menu options will vary depending on your device and version of PowerPoint. I'm using a Mac, so if you are using Office 365 for Windows or an earlier version, the options may be slightly different. But before you record, you want to make sure you have a good microphone and that it is set up correctly. Go to your System Preferences and select Sound. With input selected, you'll see what microphones are available, such as a built-in internal microphone. When you select it, you are then able to set the input volume. If you connect an external microphone, it will appear in the list. You can use a headset or even earbuds as an external microphone, and those will usually sound better than the internal mic on your computer. Select the one you plan to use, then test it to make sure it's actually recording and that the quality is good. Now we can begin recording audio. Select a slide where you want to record some audio. Now go to the Insert menu in the top panel and then Audio at the far right. Select Record Audio and a box appears with some controls. You can name each audio file Slide 1, 2, 3, or whatever you wish. You should have what you plan to say visible in the Notes panel, as you see here. When you are ready to record, click the Record button and the recording begins. Mangroves occur over a wide range of sedimentary settings. Then tap the Stop Record button, select Insert, and an audio icon appears on your slide. Hover the cursor over the icon and a player window appears. You want to play back the recording to ensure the audio is of good quality. Mangroves occur over a wide range of sedimentary settings. You can adjust the volume here. If everything sounds good, you can proceed to record audio for the rest of your slides. If not, you can delete the recording by selecting it and tapping the Delete button on your keyboard. Then re-record and continue recording the audio for the remaining slides. The last step is to save your PowerPoint file and share it. To summarize, this approach allows you to easily re-record a slide if you make a mistake. Also, you can rearrange your slides and the recorded audio will move along with the slide. If you have a lot of slides, you can easily take a break while recording instead of having to do a marathon recording session. As I mentioned in the beginning, if you want to record your image giving the presentation or create a video of your presentation rather than sharing the PowerPoint file, you'll have to take a different approach using screen capture software. This is the Scientist Videographer. Thanks for watching.